flags, colors are always treated with great reverence as they represent the honor and tradition of the unit. Colors may be inscribed with the names of battles or other symbols representing former achievement, but were always guarded by experienced or elite soldiers who protected them from loss. The capture of an enemy stand was considered a very great feat of arms. The last time that colors were carried into battle was at the Battle of Lane's Neck in the First Boer War in South Africa on the 28th of January, 1881. And when you reach Hollywood Park, you'll be offered the opportunity to take part in a major tableau of the event to commemorate the sacrifices made in the First World War. Now, ladies and gentlemen, would you please stand for the arrival of our guest of honour, the Right Honourable Lord Protestant Lord Lieutenant of the City of Edinburgh, Donald Wilson. Ladies and gentlemen, please take your seats again.
Then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, gave him up for us all. how will we not also with him gracefully give all things? Who should bring a charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? Christ Jesus is the one who died. More than that, who is raised? Who is the right hand of God? Who indeed is interceding for us? Who should separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or danger, or sword? As it is written, for your sake we were killed all the day long. We were regarded as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels nor rulers, nor things present nor things to come, nor powers, nor height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Oh,